Today we want to learn if shidduchim are really made in heaven. Is marriage made in heaven? And when you take a look at the Torah itself, in the beginning of the creation, Bereshit, we found over there some interesting things. First of all, the fact that Adam Rishon was created all alone is puzzling. Why didn't Hashem create Adam and Chava at once, just like He did to all other animals? All other animals were created males and females. What happened? Why did Adam Rishon alone, and only then Chava came along? We need to understand that few psukim beforehand, the Torah describes to us that HaKadosh Baruch Hu, not only that He didn't pour in the world, but HaKadosh Baruch Hu also made sure that nothing grew throughout the universe. Why is that? Says the Pasuk, V'chol siach hasadeh terem yeh ba'aretz. V'chol esev hasadeh terem itzmach. Nothing grew. Why? Ki lo imtir Adonai Elohim al ha'aretz. HaKadosh Baruch Hu did not pour rain on the land. Ve'adam ayin la'avod et ha'adamah. Since there's no man to work the ground. What does that mean? What's the connection between HaKadosh Baruch Hu not pouring on the ground and the fact that there's no man to work the ground? Says Rashi over there, Matam lo imtir. Why didn't HaKadosh Baruch Hu pour water into the world? Lefi she'adam ayin la'avod et ha'adamah. That is the reason. Since there's no man working the ground. Ve'en makir betovatan shel geshamim, says Rashi. Since there's nobody that understands and appreciates the rain. If there's nobody that understands and appreciates the rain coming down to the land, there's no reason for pouring rain in order to have things growing. Ukshaba adam ve'yada shem tzorech la'olam. When a man came to the world and he understood, appreciated the rain, then HaKadosh Baruch Hu was able to bring the rain. We see over here in this Rashi that there's a fascinating idea. HaKadosh Baruch Hu does not bring to the world anything if the man doesn't appreciate what was brought to him. Once there's an appreciation, there's an ability to bring things down to this world. It could be that's the idea of the Shidduch as well. Adam Rishon was created all alone. He was created all alone, and he really wanted a partner. Because when he had all the animals, all the fish, all the birds coming in front of him, he saw and named each and every one of them. But it wasn't enough, it wasn't sufficient. Since he wasn't happy, it says in the Torah that Adam was looking for somebody to be his partner, and he wasn't able to find. Says the Ramban, the reason for that is because HaKadosh Baruch Hu wanted that he should feel the desire to have somebody with him, to have a wife, a partner. And that is the understanding. As long as Adam didn't feel the need and appreciation of having Chava, he didn't have her. And Rashi told us that Adam didn't have the rain since En Makir Betovatan Shel Geshamim, since Adam Rishon did not yet appreciate the rain that's coming down to the world, he did not receive the rain. And therefore, that's so important for us to understand that when we are appreciating something, then HaKadosh Baruch Hu is able to give us that thing that we would have, and we need to cherish that. Therefore, Adam Rishon received Chava only after he felt the need to have Chava. It could be that's an important point for us when we get to Shidduchim. Why is it that HaKadosh Baruch Hu made Shidduchim so hard? Kashe zivugo shel Adam kekriyat yamsuf. It's so hard to have the Shidduch. It's so hard, it's like ripping yamsuf into parts. Why is it so hard? Why did HaKadosh Baruch Hu make it so hard? And it could be that that is exactly the understanding we explained right now. The reason is because as long as a person doesn't feel the need for that Shidduch, as it says, as people say, easy come, easy goes, which means you don't feel the appreciation for it, you're not going to appreciate what you have, and it's going to go away from you also that way, because you're not going to know how to hold it and how to keep it. As long as a person doesn't know how to keep it, he can lose it. Comes the Torah and says that Adam Rishon had a hard time finding Chava. He was searching and looking until HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave him Chava. But then he knew how to appreciate. He knew how to cherish what he has. And then he was able to keep Chava as a wife. So that is the first point. But we need to understand, really, that what is it that made Adam connect to Chava so much? The Pasuk says, Vayomer ha'adam zot apam etzem ma'atzamai, which means Adam is saying that Chava is part of him, and therefore, al ken yazov ish et aviv et imo vedavak b'ishto. When HaKadosh Baruch Hu took the bone out of Adam and created with that Chava, he said that therefore, now it's made it available for a man to leave his mother and father and attach to his wife. What's the connection between the two? Why is this a result from the fact that he took the bone? And that is also another idea that I think we can learn for shiduchim and marriage very, very precisely. And that is the fact that Adam Rishon was the first person in the universe to actually give birth. Did you ever hear of a man giving birth? There is a species in the seahorses that the male gives birth. The male becomes pregnant and gives birth. But otherwise, there's no such creation. It's always the female that is the one that giving birth. But the first creation of mankind was Adam HaRishon, and he gave birth. Where did he give birth? In this pasuk. We see that HaKadosh Baruch Hu put him to sleep, Vayapel Taredema LaAdam, he gives him the anesthesia, he gives him the epidural, and now that Adam HaRishon is out, he was able to open his side, take out a bone, close it back, sew it together, and from that, Chava was created. What is the Torah coming to teach us with that? The Torah comes to teach us an important idea that a man connects more than anybody else to his children. A man loves his children more than anything else in the world. Why is that? Because it came out of him. Something that's part of you, you love more than anybody else. Therefore, says the Mikhtav Me'eliyahu, that when a person loves somebody, it's a result of him giving the other. And if something came out of you, that's part of you. When it's part of you, you love that more than anything else. Why? What's the connection? When you give it to others, you give part of yourself. And when something came out of you, that's also part of yourself. Which means a person loves himself more than anything else in the creation. Ramban says on the mitzvah, Ve'avta le'reacha kamocha, that it's impossible to command a person to love the others like he loves himself. Because a person loves himself more than anything else in the world. So therefore he gives a different perush to that mitzvah. But the understanding we take in today is that since a person loves himself to the utmost, that's why he loves his children so much as well. Because they are his body. They came out of him. Same thing over here the Torah says with Chava. It would be impossible for a person to attach himself to his wife and become one. Vayu echad. They become one unit. Unless it would come from him himself. And therefore the Pasuk says, Al ken yazov Adam. They become one unit. How is that possible? Because it came out of him. Since Chava, since the Isha, since the woman came out of Adam, they become one unit. And therefore, since he loves the wife, he really loves himself. That brings out that love that's connecting between the two to the utmost. Otherwise, a person would not be able to love his wife to such an extent. And that is the connection over here in the Pasuk. So we learn over here that Adam HaRishon was giving birth to Chava, and that's the reason he connected so much. But what about generations to come? How could generations to come have that feeling that I love my wife to the utmost, dearly, that she's part of me. We're not giving birth to our wives. It's only Adam Rishon. So can we consider her part of me as one creation? It's hard to understand so. But that is all true when we explain for Adam Rishon. Adam Rishon gave birth to his wife, and therefore he was able to connect. But what about generations to come? How could they really connect at the utmost with their wife as considered one unit? That is when we come to a little bit more understanding in depth. And that is what the Rambam teaches us, that be'etzem, when you go to Shiduchim, a Shiduch is up to you and not already nigzal from HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Hashem Yitbarach did not decide in the Shiduch anything, rather, it's all up to you. The Rambam says in Shmona Prakim, Perikhet, the following. He says that everything you do is up to you. You have a free choice. Kol pulot ha'adam mesurim beyado. Im yirtze yaseh, ve'im lo yirtze lo yaseh. Any act you do is up to you to do or not. Mi bilti echreach shechrichu alav. Otherwise, you'll have no free choice. Ela shebnei adam to'im v'choshvim al k'tzat mipulot ha'adam ha'baot alav, shu muchrach alem. Some people think that you are obligated and you are forced to do what you're doing. That's not true. And says the Rambam is an example to that, kegon zivuk ploni, just like an example of marrying somebody. Marrying somebody is all up to you, says the Rambam. Kizot ha'isha asher lekacha hi mitzvah. Why is that? Because marrying a woman is a mitzvah, and Hashem does not get involved in you doing mitzvot. If you want to do the mitzvah, you do it. And if you don't, you don't do it. That's up to us. It's a free choice. It's not like other things that Hashem Yitbarach comes to the game and intervenes by mitzvot. Hashem tells us it's all up to you. So how could marrying a woman that is a mitzvah deoraita would be under that one would be forced to do or not to do? The Ran asks, as many others do, that we found Gemarot that says, Me'ashem isha le'ish, HaKadosh Baruch Hu is the one that's mezavek zivugim 40 yom kodem yetzirat avlad. Already HaKadosh Baruch Hu decides and determines about a shiduch. So how could that be that the Rambam says that it's all up to you? And the Ran explains that there are over here 2 points. One point is the fact, do you want to do the mitzvah or you don't want to do the mitzvah? If you want to do the mitzvah or not, that's up to you. If you decide, I want to get married, because there's a mitzvah to get married, HaKadosh Baruch Hu doesn't intervene, doesn't get involved. It's all up to you. It's your mitzvah. But who you're going to marry, that's not anymore up to you. So therefore, one has a decision. I want to get married. You want to get married? That's all considered a mitzvah, and therefore, it's all up to you. Once you decide you want to get married, HaKadosh Baruch Hu is the one that brings the shiduch to you. And he's the one that decides who will you marry. Why is that? Let's go to a story with David HaMelech. David HaMelech married Bathsheba. How could he marry Bathsheba? Was it all up to him? Or he was forced to marry her? Says the Gemara in Sanhedrin Kuf Zayin, Reuya Bathsheba le David misheshet yeme bereshit. Bathsheba was determined for David HaMelech already misheshet yeme bereshit. So says the Ben Yoyada, but 1 minute. What about the fact that 40 days before the creation of a person, there's a bat kol in Shamayim that decides who gets the shiduch? It's not done from Sheshet Yemei Bereshit. It's at the time that a person is created in the world, at the time that a woman is conceived. And therefore, what does that mean, that Reuya Bathsheba le David Misheshet Yemei Bereshit? So the Ben Yehuda has a perush over there, is mechalek between Gilgul Rishon and Gilgul Sheni, but we want to get to the Ma'alchu. Rav Chaim Vital explains the following. Rav Chaim Vital says that Be'etzem, all the neshamot of a man were all in Adam HaRishon. All the neshamot of a female were in Chava. And therefore, Adam HaRishon had all the males in him. And Chava had all the females to generations to come in her. And the shidduchim were made right then and there, says Rav Chaim Vital, at the time of creation in Adam Rishon and Chava. So what is it that Chazal tell us that 40 yom kodem yetzirat avlad bat kol yotzet ve'omeret bat ploni leploni? Rather, it's only coming to announce and say what was decided in Sheshet Yemei Bereshit, which means the shidduch already was determined in Sheshet Yemei Bereshit, not now. Now, when a person is created, now when a woman is conceived, it's only a bat kol that comes and says, yes, that shidduch is to that shidduch. This was decided already. This was decided already at the time of creation. So that comes to teach us that be'etzem, it's not up to us who we marry. The Rambam says it's only up to us if we want to get married. But once we say and decide we want to get married, that shidduch is already not only from heaven, but it's from heaven, from Sheshet Yemei Bereshit, to that extent. And therefore, when Chazal tell us that Me'ashem Isha Le'ish Min HaTorah Nevim V'Ketuvim, it's not just plain words that Hashem decides the shidduch, but rather that Hashem decided and determined the shidduch Misheshet Yemei Bereshit. So that's a fascinating thing, that Adam HaRishon, that gave birth to Chava, and therefore he was able to connect with her, that would be a kesher shel kayama. Binyana de'ad, it's only not only Adam HaRishon, rather every man and every woman that's getting married would be part of that shidduch that was done between Adam and Chava at the time of creation. So when a person comes and says, maybe she's not my shidduch, when a woman comes and says, maybe he's not my shidduch, that's impossible, because that shidduch was created and made in Sheshet Yemei Bereshit. The Gemara in Moed Katan, Yudchet Amud Bet, tells us that a person is allowed to be me'ares, to do the first part of marriage in Chol HaMoed. Shmuel Amar Mutar Le'ares Isha B'Cholo Shel Moed. Why is that? Why can't you wait for after Chol HaMoed? What's the rush? Says Shmuel, Shema Yakadmenu Acher. We're afraid that if you don't marry her right now, you don't close that tie and bound right now, you might lose her. Why? Somebody else might take her. Says the Gemara, is that possible? Ve'amar Rav, Bechol Yom Vayom Bat Kol Yotzed Ve'Omeret Bat Ploni LePloni. How could you take somebody else's shidduch? Every day, a bat kol comes out, a voice from heaven comes out to the world and says, this girl is for that boy. How could you change that creation? How could you change the fact that those are the two that are together and nobody else can come in between them? How could Shmuel say that the reason you could marry a woman in Chol HaMoed is because Shema Yekadmenu Acher, that you might be able to take somebody else's shidduch, or somebody else might be able to take your shidduch? That's impossible. Says the Gemara, Ela Shema Yekadmenu Acher Berachamim. It doesn't mean that you're able to take somebody else's shidduch, rather you could take somebody else's with rachamim, with prayer. What does that mean? Rashi gives it light over here. Rashi explains that what it means, Shema Yekadmenu Acher Berachamim, it means that one might pray that him or her will die. Which means, we're afraid that maybe if you don't close the shidduch right now in Chol HaMoed, someone might pray to Hashem Yitbarach and ask him that he should kill that. Somebody might pray to Hashem Yitbarach and asks Hashem that she shall die, that the kala shall die. And therefore, says Shmuel, that gives us the permission to marry a woman in Chol HaMoed. Fascinating. A person could accomplish that woman will die, but he can't accomplish, says Rashi and says that Gemara, to take somebody else's shidduch, which means, to that extent, you do have power to pray that she shall die, or maybe that he will die, as the Gemara later on explains as an example. But nobody has the ability to take somebody else's shidduch. It's so much stronger and so much more of a bound together that one cannot change that. It's within the creation from Sheshet Yemei Bereshit. And the Gemara says that story, Ki ha de Rava, Sham elahu gavra de bar rachme. Rava overheard somebody praying, and he said the following, Tis da men li planita, let me have that girl. I want to have that girl. He was praying to Hashem, this girl should be mine. Rava told him, no. Lo tebaye hachi. Don't pray like this. Why? If she's your shiduch, lo azlaminach. She will never leave you. You'll be together in the end. Ve'ilo kafart b'Hashem. And if not, you pray and not get her, you would say, my prayers don't help anything. They don't do anything. They don't accomplish anything. So Rava told that person and directed him, listen well. If that is your shiduch, it's not going to change at all, whether you pray or don't pray. You could pray that the shiduch will come b'itov ezmano. You could pray other things. You could have prayed that you should have a successful marriage. But if she is yours, lo azla minach, she would not be married to somebody else. Ve'ilo, and if she's not yours, she belongs to somebody else, your praying are not going to help at all. Therefore, says Rav, b'chol yom v'yom, bat kol yotzet ve'omeret, bat ploni leploni. That was done, says the Ma'archu, from Sheshet Yemei Bereshit. That was decided and determined in that shiduch between Adam and Chava. At the time that HaKadosh Baruch Hu took out the bone from Adam and connected now Adam together with himself, part of himself, Vayu Lebasar Echad. That shiduch is not only for Adam and Chava, for generations to come. It's interesting that the Gemara in Moed Katan Yutchet says, Bechol yom vayom bat kol yotzet. Every day, there's a voice from heaven saying, bat kol yotzet ve'omeret bat ploni leploni. But, the Gemara in Sota, daf bet, Sanhedrin, as well, kaf bet, says not like that. It says, 40 yom kodem yetzirat avlat bat kol yotzet. 40 days before a person is really formed in the stomach, then the bat kol is yotzet. And the Shita explains that is the time that a woman is conceived. That time, bat kol yotzet ve'omeret, but ploni leploni. The Gemara in Nida also explains more than that in Daf Tzayin, that there's a malach in Shamayim that takes that child in front of a Kadosh Baruch Hu and asks him all about his character traits. Would he be smart or not? Would he be rich or not? Strong or weak? Gibor? And so on. All these things are decided at that time, that the time of the Yibur. But we're saying over here that in one hand, the bat kol is yotzet 40 days before the creation and the formation of the child, and the other hand is bat kol yotzet bechol yom vayom. Every day a bat kol comes out. What's a pshat over here? And I thought the understanding is very simple, that a person constantly thinks, well, maybe that wasn't my shiduch. Maybe I should have married the one before her. Maybe I should have waited a little bit longer. Why did I have to rush into that shiduch? Why did I make that choice? Comes the bat kol and says, not only at the time that the child is formed, the bat kol comes out, but that was decided already at Sheshet Yemei Bereshit. And therefore, in order to make sure that a person doesn't have those regret moments and feelings, the bat kol comes out constantly, again and again and again, saying, but ploni leploni, this is your shiduch. Don't even have the second thought that maybe yes and maybe no. She is your shiduch, decided already from Sheshet Yemei Bereshit. And you know who was your shadchan? HaKadosh Baruch Hu, b'chvodo ve'atzmo, came to Adam Rishon, gave him kala in that very moment that he took out that bone from Adam Rishon. That wasn't only Adam Rishon. Yes, it's also you. Yes, it's also your wife. Yes, that was done back then. And therefore, the bat kol constantly comes every day and reminds us, don't have second thoughts. That shiduch is made in heaven indeed. But pay attention what preceded to Chava being created. Adam HaRishon is naming every creation in its own name. The animals pass through Adam HaRishon, it gives each and every animal its name. Vayikra ha'adam shemot lechol ha'behema uleof ha'shamayim ulekol chayat ha'sadeh. All the animals come in front of Adam HaRishon and he gives them a name. He names a dog to the dog. He names a cow to the cow. And so does to the birds. And so to Chayat HaSadeh. Ule'adam lo matza ezer kenegdo. But he couldn't find a helper. He couldn't find a mate. It's a connection between the two. And then HaKadosh Baruch Hu decides, now we'll give you the Chava. What's the connection between the fact that he's naming animals and that he couldn't find the Ezer Kenegdo, that now he decides, you know what? It's time to give Adam HaRishon Chava. And the explanation to that is in the Ramban. And the understanding is the following. Adam HaRishon was naming the animals. Naming the animals in Lashon HaKodesh is very different than any other language. Because in any other language, if you name a dog, dog, that's a random name that you give to that species. And so does anything else. But when we're talking about Lashon HaKodesh, the name describes the essence of that creation. When you call a dog Kelev, it has a meaning within that word. It describes what a dog is. It describes what the character traits of a dog are. And therefore, when Adam HaRishon was having all the animals pass in front of him, he saw that indeed a dog male belongs to a dog female. When he saw a horse, he knew that a horse belongs with a horse. A cow belongs with an ox. This bird belongs with that bird, because he understood the essence of that animal, of that bird, of that fish, whatever it was. He understood, he saw within it all the character traits. And therefore he decided and understood that this belongs to that. Ule'adam lo matza ezer kenegdo. He couldn't find within any of those the quality that he needs for his creation. Adam is the most unique creation of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. But he couldn't find somebody that would match him within the whole creation. And that is why HaKadosh Baruch Hu had everything else come in front of Adam HaRishon. Because when Adam HaRishon understands that there's nobody else that could be good for him, he understands when something good comes around. And that is the time that HaKadosh Baruch Hu decided, now he belongs with Chava. And this comes to teach us a fascinating thing, and that is, we need to understand that all others, whether it's animals or all other mates in the world, don't belong to us. They're not the same as us. This man belongs with that woman because HaKadosh Baruch Hu saw fit within the character traits of that person that the only one that will really be a match to him at the most intense and the most deep and the most possible way is that woman. And that woman had to have that husband, exactly him and nobody else. And therefore that shidduch was made at the most profound way at the time of creation, at the time that Adam Rishon was looking at the total creation of HaKadosh Baruch Hu and saw that nothing at all matches what he needs. And he found finally Chava. And when Chava was created, he knew this is it. Al ken yazov Adam et aviv et imo vedavak b'ishto. Why is that? Because that is the only one that really matches what that husband or what that wife needs. And within that, we're explaining right now, is not only Adam and Chava, but all male race and all female race for creation of one unit for until end of time. And that is why indeed shidduch is min hashamayim, marriage is from heaven.